Hey there guys, my name is Sparckman, welcome to this channel. Today we're going to create an isometric jumping game. Let me show you the demo. Okay, so here is the demo. I'm going to press right, left, right, and you can see that I can jump. Whoa, there's a gap there. I better not fall there. Notice that some platforms are higher than others. And if you jump upside, you die. Okay, so it's time to open the example file, which you can find under the description below. Now, if you don't know what software I'm using for making games, download the free version from the link down below. There is also a link to the paid version, which allows you to create commercial games. If you run the frame, you notice that the game scrolls, but if you push the keys, nothing happens. Let's quickly go over the assets. Right, so here is my main character, which is just a box. Here is a small object that I call jumping target. Here is my secondary object, which is going to be a pinball object, and that's for our jumping. Now, if you double click on the blocks, you can see that we have three directions. One is higher than the other. I'm using these red blocks to spawn more blocks. I'm using the layers object for scrolling. Now, if you don't know how to do the scrolling, check out this video. Let's go to the event editor. Now, this game is probably more suitable for cell phones and tablets, but we're gonna make it for PC. So we're gonna use the keyboard. If the user presses the right key or the left key, if the user presses right, we're going to destroy our main character. And we're gonna create a jumping object just like the last tutorial. Relative to the main character's position, we're gonna set the direction of the jumping object to 7. Try it out. That sort of works. If our jumping object is facing direction 7, we're gonna repeat this only once when this event loops. We're gonna set the speed of the object to 76. 76. Try it out. That's not too bad. Copy line 4, paste it. Change the direction to 9. And because of the jumping angle, we have to change the speed to 64. Line 3, let's change the direction to 9. Try it out. Right. And left. Line 2, we're gonna change the position of the jumping target to over here. And for line 3, we're going to simply set this to minus 67. Let's bring our target to front. Always order, bring to front, right out. That works fine. Do it for the left, and that works fine. Now, collision between our jumping object and our target, and our target is overlapping another object. In this case, it's going to be the block. We're gonna destroy the jumping object, and then we're gonna create our original object again. Create object, main, relative to the position of the jumping object. Try it out. That works fine. Whoa, we run out of blocks. Now, since we're cheating and we're not using the trigonometry, okay, math. Who told you how to use math for this? Now, to ensure a consistent position, we are going to, if our target collides with the blocks, then we're going to change the position of the target relative to the position of the blocks right here. Right out. You can see that the position of the orange object is consistent. So now we just need to generate blocks. We're gonna use the timer to create the blocks every 328 milliseconds. We're gonna create a block relative to one of these red blocks. Try it out. Jump, jump, jump. And that works fine, except for we're missing some blocks. Now to fix that gap, all we have to do is at the start of the frame, we do the same thing. Get out. There are the blocks. Yeah, jumping on the blocks. Now if you keep jumping, you're gonna notice that your character is going to eventually desynchronize with your game. We're gonna fix that. Line 6, we're going to change the position of the normal block relative to the target. Somewhere around there. Thread out. And you can see that the normal block adjusts its position every time it lands. And notice that we're not using any math to get this done. So if your teacher says, hey, you need math to make games, you can say, no, you don't. Check out this video. Okay, I'm not saying don't do math. I'm just saying that you don't need math for this. Math is good for you. 2 + 2 = 10, obviously. Okay, so let's make this invisible at start. But now we're missing the different heights. To fix that, we are going to, if you double click on the blocks, you can see that we have two types of blocks. You can have more if you wanted to. So all we have to do is change the direction of the blocks. So under line 8, we're going to change the direction of the blocks to these three directions. But if the block is facing up direction, then we're going to destroy it. Destroy. We can do this at the start of the frame as well. There is our first tall block. There is our first gap. Another tall block. If you like this video, hit the like button. And if you didn't like the video, smack the dislike button. And now it's time for the first and top comment. And today's top comment came from Sifflin Hat Gaming.
I can't even switch my lobbies. Since I am here's on right now for Roblox I downloaded.
And now it's time for the first comment. And the first comment is Ghost Killer 231.
So now it's season 2
of Sky Wars. Alright, so don't forget to subscribe to the channel, follow me on Twitter, and I will see you in the next episode. Bye now.